Hi, I'm Andrew Atkinson, and we're here at the Mac Adams Open Day with Master Baker Joss, who will be demoing how baking meets cooking. A few of the demonstrations that we'll be doing will be the olive and parmesan buns, the salmon with halloumi and spring onion wrapped in puff pastry, and the parma ham goat's cheese lattice done in puff pastry. All the recipes can be obtained on the Hudson Mark website. Enjoy.
Alright, well, it's great to be here down in Cape Town at Mac Adams. I'm obviously ambassador of Hudson Knight, who do the superior fats, oils. Joss is the master baker. How are you, Joss?
All right, and you?
Are you very good?
All right, okay. We're together in Mac Adams.
So obviously what we've done is we've come with innovation between baking, because a lot of the, where the fats and everything, the pastry fats come together with cooking. And what we've done, we've got a few little examples on the go, we've just got one on the oven. What I'm going to be showing you is little olive puff pastry bites. Superior puff pastry, which Joss made this morning. Obviously I'm going to take, Joss will take you through and tell you a little bit about the puff pastry shortly. We've layered that obviously with the premium fat. Which fat do we use on this one?
Patriots.
Right, so we use the Patriots, a high quantity of fat, layered in, broken in, so it's going to get nice evening, nice raisination in there. We've got the green pitted olives, and we've got some parmesan cheese. You can put those together, fold them all over, cut them into, you're supposed to put them in the freezer so they're hard enough. Cut them into nice little strips, bake them off at 170 to 180 degrees, put them up as a nice little bar snack, and voila, there you go.
The whole idea is to actually bring the two together, the cooking and the baking. And you know, puff pastry, quality of puff pastry is what you're going to get in, it's what you're going to get out. So with other words, is if you want to make a good puff pastry today, or if it's a Danish pastry, the amount of quality and the quality of fat that you're going to put in that particular paste, that's going to be dictated to the products that you're going to have. Okay, so here, it's an idea from Andrew here, that he came up and said, what can we do to actually make it a little bit more attractive? And one of these ideas that he came up with was with the olives and puff pastry, which can be used as a perfect snack.
That is a bar snack, so when the bar goes open, hopefully there's a few of these and you can tuck them in your pocket, bring it out, and you've got your bar snack ready for you. Obviously a nice little sheet of puff pastry, nice, not too thin. You would put in the olives, pitted olives, the green pitted with a bit of pigmento in there for a little bit of bite. Those are going down, and Joss is steaming ahead while I'm talking. That's why I love doing the demo. Someone else doing it for you. So great, thank you. Good to have you with me, Joss.
Thank you very much.
So obviously three little lines. You're obviously leaving a gap, a finger's width between each one. And then obviously you see we've used about a third of one side of the puff paste. We're going to egg wash it down because we're going to fold it over. But make sure you get a nice, good coating of the egg wash on that pastry. Brush away any excess flour because that's just going to prevent it from sticking. And then we need some parmesan cheese. So, good help in a parmesan that really lifts the flavors of these olives. Olives obviously have been soaked in brine and they've got that saltiness to them. So you're going to be very careful when seasoning. But a nice helping of that rich parmigiano. Thank you.
Thank you.